Good morning children. Distance formula. Distance formula is for finding the distance between the two points if the coordinates of the points are given. Other than finding the distance between the points, it has other uses or other applications also. Let's see which are the other applications of distance formula. First one, as we said, it is mainly for finding the distance between the two points. Second, to check the collinearity of points. Third, to decide the type of triangle. Four, to decide the type of quadrilaterals. And fifth, to do the problems related with equidistant points. Let's check. Here, see the points A, B and C are collinear. What are collinear points? Points that lie on the same line are called collinear points. If they do not lie on the same line, we call them as non-collinear points. Using distance formula, how can we check the points are collinear? See, if the points A, B and C are collinear, geometrically it is very clear that length of AB plus length of BC is equal to length of AC. What we have to do is, using the formula, first find the length AB. Then find the length BC. Then find the length of AC. Then find AB plus BC. If AB plus BC is equal to AC, we can say points are collinear. Suppose on finding the length of AB, we got it as 3 units. Then after finding that, find the length of BC. Suppose we got BC as 5 units. Third, you should find AC. If we get AC as 8 units, see 3 plus 5 equal to 8. That means AB plus BC equal to AC. In this case, we can say the points A, B and C are collinear. Here, for finding the length AB, use distance formula. To find the length BC, use distance formula. To find the length AC, you use distance formula. Okay, what is the next application? To decide the type of triangles, there are three types of triangle based on the length of sides. The first one is equilateral triangle. You know, in equilateral triangle, the three sides are equal. Isosceles triangle is a triangle in which the two sides are equal. And third one is scalene triangle, in which no side equal. Using the formula, how can we decide the type of triangle? Suppose it is triangle ABC or any triangle. Using the formula, the coordinates of these three vertices will be given to us. Using distance formula, find the first side, then second side, find the length of the third side. If the length of the three sides are equal, triangle will be equilateral. If only two sides are equal, it will be isosceles, and three sides different means it will be scalene. See, we have to find the length of side using distance formula. For finding the length of this side, it will be x1y1, x2y2 and proceed like that. Then the second side, then the third side. Okay. Next one is to decide the type of quadrilateral. Which are the different type of quadrilaterals? Quadrilateral is a polygon with four sides. There are the main quadrilaterals are, first one is a parallelogram. What is a parallelogram? Parallelogram is a quadrilateral in which the opposite sides are equal. Then we will be confused. Rectangle is also like that. In rectangle also the opposite sides are equal. So how can we differentiate parallelogram and rectangle? In parallelogram and rectangle, the pairs of opposite sides are equal. But the difference is in the case of diagonals. In parallelogram, diagonals are not equal, but in a rectangle, diagonals are equal. So, we can say parallelogram, opposite sides are equal, diagonals are not equal. But in rectangle, opposite sides are equal, diagonals are also equal. The same thing happens in the case of rhombus also. Rhombus and square. Rhombus, four sides are equal, diagonals are not equal, and square, four sides are equal, diagonals are equal. Using distance formula, if the vertices of a quadrilateral is given, how to conclude whether it is a parallelogram, rectangle, rhombus, or square? So let's first find the lengths of the side. The lengths of the four sides should be find using distance formula. If we see the opposite sides equal, pairs of opposite sides only equal, can be either a rectangle or a parallelogram. To avoid the confusion, find the length of the diagonals also. Okay, if the four sides, the pairs of opposite sides are equal, diagonals are equal, it will be a rectangle. If the opposite sides are equal, diagonals not equal, it will be a parallelogram. And if the four sides are seem to be equal and diagonals not equal, it will be a rhombus. And if the four sides are equal and diagonals are also equal, it can be a square. Okay. And to do the problems with the equidistant points. What are equidistant point? Points which are equally away from a particular point. So let's take a point P here and take another point A at a distance of 3 units from P. Okay, then take another point B which is also at 3 units away from P. See, now the length from P to A equal to length from P to B. That is PA equal to PB. Here A and B are equally away from the point P, or A and B are equidistant points. Okay, so we have to write, we can say PA equal to PB. This happens only in the case of non-collinear points. See, the case of collinear points, if the point A is here and P is here, and if the point B is here, PA is certainly equal to PB, but other more than that, P will be the midpoint. The midpoint case we will be studying in the next content. Now we have to talk about, we are talking only about non-collinear points. So PA equal to PB if A and B are equidistant point from. Okay, now we are moving to the problem of all the things that we already discussed. The first application was to check the collinearity of points. There we discussed if the points A, B, C are collinear, AB plus BC will be equal to AC. We have to check it. First find AB. If you want, you can draw a figure over here. A is here and B can be in the middle, and not in the middle, an interior point, and C here. First find the length AB. Here see, length AB, coordinates of A should be written here, B here, and coordinates of C should be written here. And AB, using distance formula, AB is equal to root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square, root of 6 minus 3 whole square plus 4 minus 1 whole square, root 9 plus 9, root 18 is 3 root 2. How root 18 is 3 root 2? Root 18 can be written as root 9 into 2. That is root 9 into root 2. Root 9 is 3, root 2 is root 2 only. So 3 root 2. And similarly, BC, 8 minus 6 whole square, root of 8 minus 6 whole square plus 6 minus 4 whole square. Again, root 4 plus 4 is root 8. It is, root 8 is root of 4 into 2. Root 4 is 2. Root 2 is root 2 itself. So, 2 root 2. Then for finding AC, AC is root of 8 minus 3 whole square plus 6 minus 1 whole square. Root 25 plus 25, root 50. Root 50 is root of 25 into 2. Root 25 is 5, root 2 is root 2. And here see, AB 3 root 2 and BC 2 root 2 and AC 5 root 2. Certainly, AB plus BC is 3 root 2 plus 2 root 2 which is equal to 5 root 2 which is AC. So, AB plus BC equal to AC. So, we can say here AB plus BC equal to AC. So, we can say the points AB and C are collinear points. Next example, determine if the points 1, 5, 2, 3 and minus 2, 11 are collinear. Similarly, you can call this point as A, B and C. First find the length AB, it is root 5. Length BC, 2 root 53. Length AC, root 265. In this case, we are not getting AB plus BC is not equal to AC. Here, AB plus BC is not equal to AC. Sum of two sides is not equal to the third side. Okay. So, this case, the points are non-collinear. Okay, the points are non-collinear. They are not collinear. And see, the next problem is about deciding the type of triangles. Here, see, you are given three points. Three points are given to us. 5 minus 2, 6, 4 and 7 minus 2. So, you can draw a rough triangle if needed. This is vertex A, B and C. Using distance formula, find the length AB. Here, 6 minus 5 whole square, root of 6 minus 5 whole square plus 4 plus 2 whole square is equal to root 37. AB is root 37. Similarly, BC is root 37. And AC using distance formula is 2. Okay. So, we can conclude AB equal to BC, but it is not equal to AC. AC is different. Since the two sides are equal, we can say the triangle is isosceles. And next, to decide the type of quadrilateral, we are given the vertices of a quadrilateral. See, three problems are here. We have done only one problem, the first one. Quadrilateral with the vertices minus 1, minus 2, 1, 0, minus 1, 2 and minus 3, 0. And these can be the vertices of a parallelogram. First, name the parallelogram. If you want, you can draw the figure, not compulsory. ABCD is a parallelogram. Naming the parallelogram should be done very carefully. It should be written either clockwise or anti-clockwise. Okay. So, using distance formula, find the length of AB. In the place of A, the point will be minus 1, minus 2. In the place of B, point will be 1, 0. And C will be the point minus 1, 2. And D will be the point minus 3, 0. Find the length AB. Then find length BC, CD and DA. Here, length of AB is 2 root 2, length of BC is 2 root 2 and length of CD is 2 root 2 and DA is also 2 root 2. Means the four sides are equal. If the four sides are equal, it can be either a rhombus or a square. To decide whether it is a rhombus or a square, we have to find the length of the diagonal also. Here see, diagonal AC is 4 units and diagonal BC is 4 units. So, we got the four sides are equal, diagonals are also equal. So, certainly the quadrilateral will be a square. And the problems related with the equidistant points. Question is, find a relation between x and y such that the point xy is equidistant from the point 3, 6 and minus 3, 4. As we discussed before, Pxy is, see, relation between x and y, if the point xy, let's mark the point P here. P is the point xy. And another point A here and the point B here, and the coordinates of A, and B are also given, so point A and B. Okay, coordinates of A are 3, 6 and coordinates of B are minus 3, 4. Since the point A and B are equidistant points, we can say PA equal to PB, that is AP equal to BP. AP using distance formula is root of x minus 3 whole square plus y minus 6 whole square. BP using distance formula is x plus 3 whole square plus y minus 4 whole square. Simplifying this, x minus 3 whole square expanding using a minus b whole square, we will get it. Y minus 6 whole square expand using a minus b whole square. X plus 3 whole square expand using a plus b whole square. Y minus 4 whole square is expanded using a minus b whole square. Expanding and transposing all the terms to LHS and simplifying, we will get minus 12x minus 4y plus 20 equal to 0. It is divisible by minus 4, so it is reduced to 3x plus y minus 5 equal to 0 is the relation. So relation between x and y is certainly an equation in x and y. Okay, these are the main applications of distance formula. Thank you.